These little CubeSats are revolutionizing satellite science. But do you think something this small is big enough to help NASA gather science data? Let's find out.
We currently have an Earth-orbiting satellite called Raven. It's been up there for about a year. Raven stands for Radiometer Assessment of Vertically Aligned Carbon Nanotubes. So Raven measures the Earth's radiation imbalance. So how much energy is getting absorbed by the Earth and how much gets reflected back? That's a big question that's an important parameter for climate science. Raven serves as a pathfinder for a constellation. The idea is to put a constellation of these small satellites around the globe so you can get simultaneous measurements of the radiation reflecting back out into space. The future of CubeSats is very bright. The more that we demonstrate technologies, the more we can incorporate into science, and the more CubeSats can go up and take simultaneous data. For example, you could have simultaneous global measurements around the Earth, measuring things that you could never have imagined before. With the swarm of CubeSats, we could have rapid refresh over natural disasters, such as cyclones or hurricanes. The advantage of swarming over typical satellite is that you don't have to send commands up and down because they already know what to do next.
CubeSats are changing the way we are collecting information and allowing more and more people access to space because they are less expensive. Kids like you and me have opportunities to get involved by designing and building our own CubeSats that could be launched by NASA. Want to know more? Check out this site and click on the NASA CubeSat Launch Initiative, or CSLI. They might be small, but CubeSats are providing answers to big questions. That's all for now. See you next time on NASA eClips.